Oh, okay. We can do the boomerang.
Should we do boomerang? Yeah. Yeah, do that.
I'll do my own boomerang.
Ready?
All right.
Tattooed, a Port City tattoo. I got tattooed by Austin Maples for the Open Road tattoo tour. I mean, he's one of those tattoo artists that really stands out. He's got such a distinct tattoo style. And a lot of my tattoos, I mean, I love traditional tattoo. You can just kind of pick a flash and it's something that'll stick with you. It's timeless. None of my tattoos really have a big meaning, but I collect tattoos from everybody.
I heard about Austin Maples actually just on social media. I was browsing through Instagram, saw some pretty cool traditional tattoos I liked, and I kind of just found his profile by mistake, and then ever since then I've been like a huge fan. I've been kind of waiting to get up to San Francisco to see him, but I lucked out on the tour.
Rob Sasson down here at Port City Tattoo in Long Beach, California. I just got a tattoo from Brian Thurow. I was actually just a walk-in. I came in the other day and they had happened to have Brian as a guest here at the shop. And then I met him, got to know him a little bit, and seemed like a really nice guy. I liked all of his work. So I scheduled an appointment with him and then came in the next day after work. He's a bit of a perfectionist. So he won't walk away until it's exactly the way he wants it to look. So I like that a lot. I actually have a cock tattooed inside of my leg, a rooster. I got that in Japan when I was on a deployment with about six of my buddies. And we all went into the same spot and all got a rooster on the inside of our leg. It's probably the dumbest tattoo I have, but one of the best memories I got.
Moser, owner of Port City Tattoo here in Long Beach. We've been open since 2011, opened up in the traffic circle right on PCH. You know, I like our customers to feel comfortable when they come in the shop, be greeted, do a quick consult, kind of feel them out, see exactly what they're wanting, and then go from there. You know, I treat other artists, other shops with respect, and I would like them to do the same for me. I was taught, you know, never be opening up on anybody. Don't try to undercut anybody, and the golden rule, basically. But, you know, there's a lot of new tattooers that maybe didn't have the same type of mentorship that I had and are kind of figuring things out on their own and maybe are young, so they're just kind of doing their thing. And I can't say that it's wrong, but, you know, there's definitely a respectful way to go about things in any business. We have a good amount of guest artists. It's always fun to see what they're doing, see what kind of machines or ink or whatever, or, you know, exchange stories. Usually go out dinner, go out, have some drinks afterwards. So it's always fun having guest artists in town, especially these dudes. It's been a lot of fun.
Here at Port City Long Beach, getting tattooed by Paul Dobelman for the Open Road Tattoo Tour. I just started following a lot of people, a lot of tattooers on Instagram, and his popped up one day, I think, as a suggestion. And this was years ago. I've been following him ever since, and he's become one of my favorite tattooers. It's very traditional, but it's very unique to him. Like, you see a Paul Dobelman tattoo, and you know it's a Paul Dobelman tattoo. The first time I got tattooed by Paul, it's probably my favorite, because it was a Christmas gift from my wife. She set everything up. I had no idea. I mean, it was a total surprise. She did her homework and found out that Paul's one of my favorites and scheduled the appointment. And we flew up to San Francisco, spent the whole weekend up there together. And then I went into the shop at Spider Murphy's and got tattooed the last day we were there. And then we flew out that night. It was just a great tattoo and a great experience.
Put on the side, baby. Give me that, motherfucker. Damn,
rolling.
Yeah, 4, 5, 6.
5.
Still on the
stay
roll.
Five with that 5.
Come on.
Tie 3.
Oh! Who called money? Who called money? Who called money? Who called money?
You know what? That.
Oh.
Oh.
Fuck.
I didn't get in. Yeah.
Yeah.
I had to jump the toy in, bro.
Nice job.
Are we going again?
Yeah.